So, okay, let's start my talk. And hello, JSConf Asia. And today I'd like to talk about exploring future Node.js. And okay, first of all, so let me introduce myself. So my name is Yosuke Furukawa, and I'm working for the Recruit Technologies. And I'm some faces, and I am an organizer of NodeFest at Tokyo. NodeFest is a very big conference at Tokyo, and I'm a leader of Node.js Japan User Group, and I am also Node.js collaborator and Node.js evangelist. So my Twitter handle name is Yosuke_Furukawa, and my GitHub account name is Yosuke-Furukawa. And actually, I'm the creator of the hexagonal sticker site, the named Hexi. And this site can send hexagonal stickers on worldwide. And so JSConf Asia has stickers, the so cool stickers. And that is not the hexagonal one. So organizer, please create some cool stickers on this site. And I have lots of stickers. I put stickers on the front desk, like this one. Yeah. And please pick up my stickers and feel free to ask me. Yeah. So let's go back to my talk, and I will introduce about the Node.js and the past and present and the future. Yeah. So yeah, my slide has 70 pages and some demos. I will introduce this one quickly. So I would like to introduce the past Node.js features from Node v4.x to v6.x. Yeah, Node.js has lots of features. These features are just my favorites. And inspect mode with Chrome and Intel built-in object and stable and performance. So I will show you the demo for inspect mode with Chrome. So before this feature, so we need to use the Node Inspector. It is a third-party module, but Node v6.3, you don't need to use any third module libraries. Just you need Node and Chrome. So I will show you the demo. Oops. Yeah, here is an the code. Yeah, just I create the Yeah, it's no problem. Yeah, you need to drag over. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is an code. I just create the typical HTTP server. And so you put the node dash dash inspect and dash dash debug break, and you can execute the server.js. And then, so this CLI shows the Chrome DevTools URL. So you need to access this URL. And then, And then you copy this URL and paste it to the Chrome. And then you can see the debug mode. So currently, so I break this first line. So I forward this one. And then I will go to my site and stop. Yes, here is the breakpoint. So we break the less.end, and if you want to go forward, then you can get the hello world. And and you can change this hello world to some other messages and like a JSConf.Asia, like this, and forward, then you can get hello JSConf Asia. that is the inspect mode with Chrome. That is a cool feature, isn't it? I think. Okay. And okay, next is an internationalization API. I called this API as Intel. Intel is a new built-in object for internationalization API. This API exposes the format APIs for internationalization, like number and date time, and compare to string, et cetera, et cetera. Yeah. So you can use this one is a Japanese syrup, the Japanese text. Yeah. And next is a Node.js benchmarking working groups. Node.js benchmarking working group measures the performance on every day. And this chart shows that Node.js v7.0 is faster than other versions. Yeah, it's so great. And these features is continuously in every day. Yeah. So, okay, next slide is shows the current Node.js v7.0. Yeah, congratulations, the Node.js v7.0 is released on the 25th October. And Node.js v7.0 has some various changes. I will introduce some notable changes. Node v7 has two notable changes. The first one is ES2016 support, and the second one is new URL parser. Yeah, I will introduce the ES2016 plus support. Here is a compatibility table. This chart is a compatible table. So you can see at Node Green in this table. And as you can see, so Node v7.1.0 achieves 99% support on ES2015. And in case of ES2016, we achieve 100% support. So you can use ES2016 has two representative features. The first one is exponential operator. The two asterisk 3 becomes 8. And the second one is array plot type includes. This is similar to index of, but it indicates it returns a Boolean. Node v7 supports both features natively. And in case of ES2017, we achieved a 62% cover. And we can use async await behind the flag, and --harmony-async-await, yeah, is the flag. So yeah, I will show you the demo before this. I will show you the async await demo. So this code is classic callback style. So I think you write this style code. Yeah, when execute this code, you can copy the data. We can use a promise on the node v4.0. The promise can avoid callback error easily. It's like this one, it's like this. And finally, so we can use async await on node v7.0. So that is extremely useful to avoid callback error. But currently, this feature is experimental. You need to put the --harmony-async-await, the flag. So I will show you the async await demo. Yeah, this is an async await code. So you can use this style, and you need to declare the async function, and you need to call the await in this function. Yeah. And oops, sorry. And --harmony. Oops. Async await. Then yeah, you can get done. But it is not so cool demo. But yeah, you can get the copy data in here. OK. Okay, let's go back to my talk. So yeah, you can use async await in Node v7.0 behind the flag. And the second notable change is a new URL parser. So we already have URL parser in Node core. The URL parser can pass URL string to URL object and stringify the object to URL string. It's like this, like this style code. And the new URL parser is here, and require URL dot URL is can be loaded the new URL parser. So you can use the new URL API in a URL sentences to get to create URL object. So and the stringify URL object just to use a to string. Oops. So actually, this URL parser is defined by the FATWG working group, and they determine the web standard APIs and HTMLs, et cetera, et cetera. Yeah. So as I showed, Node.js V7 does not have so cool features like inspector mode, isn't it? Yeah. And but these features follow the web standard. ES2016 is based on ECMA 262. And a new URL parser is based on the FATWG URL. These features brings Node.js to web standard. These features brings Node.js to the web standard. Yeah. And the next is, and I would like to introduce the future Node.js. The next Node.js will be major version is V8.x. And future Node.js also moves forward to the web standard. And I introduced two features. HTTP2, it is based on IETF working groups. And ES modules, it is based on ECMAScript working groups. Yeah. The first one is HTTP2. HTTP2 is a new version of HTTP. So RFC 7540 is already published by IETF, and our release target, HTTP2 support release target is Node V8. Yeah, and HTTP2 main goal is to decrease the latency. HTTP2 has a lot of features to focus on decrease latencies, and data compression and fixing head of line blocking, and server push and prioritization request, et cetera, et cetera. So why HTTP2 needs these features? So request header is becoming so huge, and method and scheme and host and pass is not so huge, but so user agent and cookies and some other custom headers are getting longer. So I will show you some examples. So yeah, this is an simple, yeah, left browser is i6. Yeah, i6 user agent is so simple. It's like this one. But right browser is MSH. User agent is so long header. And HTTP2 can compress such a headers. So this diagram shows the compression headers. So HTTP2 has a dictionary table, and the table can compress the headers. So we can reduce the size of the headers. Yeah, it's like this one. Yeah. And HTTP2 is fixing the head of line blocking. So, and I would like to introduce the head of line blocking. The browser can send 6 requests concurrently. But if one request is slow or failed, the browser can use only 5 requests when the request is finished. So this is HTTP 1.1 problem, head of line blocking. HTTP2 has new features to fix the head of line blocking. So HTTP2 multiplex requests on one TCP connection. If some requests are slow, so but whole requests are not affected, so you can, so this feature is fixing the head of line blocking. Okay, next. And HTTP2 on Node Core using the energy HTTP2 library. And so Node.js already have an HTTP parser inside, but energy HTTP2 has own parser, so we have two libraries to speak HTTP and HTTP2. Yeah. So, okay, I will introduce the HTTP2 API. So here is a sample of HTTP2 code of Node Core. So you need to use an require http.http2, so you can get the HTTP2 modules. And the other API is similar to the current HTTP modules. This API usage is not so different from the current HTTP module. And this is a HTTPS mode, and we need to use http://create-secure-server. This API is a little bit different from the current HTTPS module, so I will show you a demo using this code. Okay, here is an HTTP2 secure mode, HTTPS mode, HTTP2 code. Okay. And, So browser cannot speak the HTTP2 in a plain mode, plain text mode. So you need to use HTTPS in this demo. Okay. Oops. Sorry. Okay. This is an HTTP 2, and this is not so cool, but you can get this message from the HTTP2 server. So I will show you the demo to use Node Core HTTP2 modules. So first of all, so HTTP2 status in Core is pretty work in progress. And the current HTTP2 status is, as I said, it's a strongly work in progress. And we don't support prioritization and server push, and we need help from the community side opinions. And we are discussing and send some pull requests in this repository, so github.com/node.js/http2. And the next feature is, next future Node.js feature is the ES module's interoperability. This feature release target is Node V7, V10, maybe. And ES modules interop is quite difficult. So ES module interoperability is, and as you know, so Node.js uses own common JS-like module load system. And however, so JavaScript defines the new module system in ES 2015. So it is called the import/export. And we need to show users the options to choose both Node Common JS and ES module styles. And I would like to introduce the ES modules. So ES modules' main goals are 2 points. The first one is new declarative grammar. This goal introduces the tools friendly, and we can detect errors easily. And ES module is friendly for JavaScript engines also, and engines can optimize easily. And ES module have new strict rules. You need to think ES module is a new script. Okay, I will show you some examples. When common JS style, error detection is not so easy. So this code is not error. Just double declarations. Here is the example of the ES modules. Export default is doubled, so this syntax goes error and pass the module. So you can judge the ES module. You can detect the errors easily. And next example is here. And this example is exports the property of the foo. This CommonJS sentence exports the property foo. Yeah. But import script is loading a bar. So this is, but this is not error. A bar is just undefined. In case of ES modules, we have new syntax. A new syntax can detect errors when load the modules. So the above code introduced syntax error. So bar is not found. We can also detect syntax error on parsing. And the ES module is friendly for JavaScript engines. So Microsoft Edge experimentally implements ES modules. The browser Edge, browser engine Chakra is optimizing lookup ES modules. So according to the MS Edge blog article, so Chakra can allocate the physical storage for the export before execution. And for an import, Chakra resolves the import name and create a link back to the export it refers to. And Chakra can skip the dynamically looking up the export name in execution timing. And module is new script. Module has some differences with legacy, current script, and so some 3 points and implicit strict mode, different scopes, and already defined reserved keywords like await. So these examples are the module's new rules. So you cannot use the with sentences in ES modules because ES modules runs under strict mode implicitly. And you cannot access top-level this. Top-level this is undefined. And the scope is also different. So if you define the top-level scope variables, that does not leak the global variables. And await is the new reserved keyword in ES modules. So you can get a syntax error. Await is reserved in ES modules. I think this ES modules will be next JavaScript good parts. However, currently we are still discussing a lot. So this is FATWZ loader spec repository. So loader spec is still under discussion. And the V8 is also work in progress. So current status is here. And ES module determines the grammar and the script tag spec. However, other topics are still under discussion. ES module loader spec and the implementation by V8 and the interop implementation by Node.js is still under discussion. So discussion. So ES module is currently lots of discussions. Loader spec is under discussion, and the ES module's new spec is also under discussion, and interop is also under discussion. And the node need to judge the imported JavaScript is module or script. Current node proposals looks at the file extension. .js is script, but .mjs is module. So this proposal have lots of comments, and someone writes counter proposals named defense of .js. And as I said, so before, this is still discussing. So if you want to, if you have some comments, so please go to this repository and write some issues. It's good. And my suggestion is to not to use ES modules under transpilers like Babel on current status. So because current transpiler cannot follow the standard. So if you are using the import-export using a transpiler, so you may change your code to use native ES modules in the future. So as I showed, Node.js features are based on some standards. Internationalization API is based on ECMA 402. And ES 2016, ES modules are based on ECMA 262. The new URL parser is based on WebRTC, and HTTP 2 is based on IETF. And why Node needs the web standards? So James Snell is talking in talking about that in NodeFest 2016. So Node.js is and has been primarily a platform for web application development. While Node.js presumes a small core philosophy for most things, it includes support for the most basic and critical internet standards. So I would like to wrap up this talk. And why Node needs standards? That we are focusing on keep Node ecosystems better. So ECMAScript and other internet standard will be next community standard. So Node.js would be better to follow those standardization. Okay, thank you for listening to my talk. And please come in next NodeFest 2017 at Tokyo, and we will serve you the super delicious sushis. Thank you so much.